I want to look at another example in optimization. This time from hotel revenue, and this time we will need to build the function that we're talking about. So we'll do that together. Again, looking at keywords, and again, please pay attention over and over again to translating this verbal description into some sort of mathematical problem. Okay? So this is again from your textbook. A 210-room hotel is filled when the room rate is $50 a day. For each $1 increase in the rate, three fewer rooms are rented. So the rate goes up and you don't get as many people staying there. Find the room that maximizes daily revenue. Okay? So let me just take some notes. I mean, in these word problems. So the hotel has 210 rooms and it's full, right, at $50 a day. Okay. For a $1 increase in price, I get three fewer rooms, right? Okay, and then the final one. I want to find the room rate, I think that is. Find the room rate that maximizes daily revenue. So maximize revenue based on price. Okay. This last sentence tells me that this should be the output of whatever function that I'm going to create, and that price of the room should be the input. Okay. Now there are several ways to work this problem, but that's kind of where I get to. And this idea of kind of identifying output and input before we begin is helpful. Okay? And now I'm thinking to myself, well, I don't know how to figure out this revenue price equation. And so maybe I need to just make some notes, but I probably do know how to figure out what the revenue is based on the actual. Like, if I knew what the price was, right? So let me just say, like, if I start here and the price, I know if it's $50, right? The number of rooms I get rented, oops, I don't want, number of rooms rented is 210, right? So my revenue in that case, I think I'm going to need some more room here. Hold on. Let me erase this one. I want to leave enough room. But revenue here in this first case is 50 times 200, right? Or 210. Just the price times how many rooms I rented. Easy. Okay, now I also know kind of what pattern this is. If I raise the rate to $51, I rent three fewer rooms, 207. And really, I don't want to think of this as 207. I want to think of this as 210 minus 3, right? Because I want to make a connection here. And then again, still here, this is 51 times 210 minus 3, right? Or times 207. That's how I get the revenue. So I'm getting the revenue by multiplying these first two columns, okay? Now, so I think if I could figure out a pattern for this column stuff, then I could figure out the revenue. If it's 52, the next pattern is this is 210, and I have to subtract 3 twice, right? So there is some kind of maybe additional thing like number of rate hikes to me that's coming into play that might help us see this. So, but when I raise the rate by $1, I get P is 51. That's 50 plus this rate hike. So let's put this, maybe I'll do this as N. That's 50 plus 1 or 50 plus N, right? Here is 50 plus 2. And then here, I really am subtracting and I want to just make sure, like this is 210 minus 3 twice, which is minus 2 times 3. So I think this N, let me see, is coming into play right here and right here. Do you see this pattern? Just based on a table, just based on writing. So let me do another one. So that's the second rate hike. There's so many colors. Okay, so 3, right? Let's raise the price to $53. Then I have to subtract 3 three times, right? So I get down to, let's see, this one was 204. I think this one is 201, right? And this, based on the pattern, is 210 minus 3 times 3. Now, this is my $3 price decrease, and this is how many times I raised the, or this is my 3 room, right, decrease. Of 3 rooms for this $1 increase in price. Okay? Okay, let's go down. Let me do one more. And then we'll try and write this general pattern. If I raise the price 4 times, it's 54, 210, and I have to subtract 3 4 times, which in terms of this pattern that I'm trying to create, it's like that. Okay? And we said the revenue is this P, $54, times whatever this 210 minus 4 times 3, right? Times the number of rooms rented. Okay. So let's go down. I want to then here. So when I, in just in general, when I raise the rate n times, this price is 50 plus n, right? If I raise it 5 times, it should be 55. If I raise it 6 times, so that's my price. And then I should get this 210 minus n times 3. Something like that. Okay? And then in that case, revenue should be this price times rooms rented. Okay. Now, like I said, I want to try and get a function R of P. So let me write this stuff down. I would like P, not N, to be my variable. Okay? So here I have this function P is equal to 50 plus N, right? Or I can turn that around, N is equal to P minus 50. Okay? I think that's what I'm going to use. And then the number of rooms rented, so this is my price. Number of rooms rented. In terms of price, right? Is this 210 minus n times 3? But I can put in this p minus 50, right? For n times 3. And so I'll go ahead and do that. 3p. And this is, I think, plus 150? Is that what you guys get? So I think I'm getting here, let's see, 360 minus 3p for the number of rooms rented. Okay? So now, revenue as a function of price is equal to the price times number of rooms rented. This is all just building my function. I haven't taken any derivatives. I haven't maximized anything. Just building. So I have this price, which is just P. I don't have to do N in there. I'm just using P. And then times the number of rooms rented, 360 minus 3P. Okay? There's my function. Revenue is a function of price. Let me multiply that out so I get 360P minus 3P squared. And I do a quick check of this. I'm trying to maximize revenue. And I view this or recognize this as an upside down parabola that should have a maximal value, right? So I want to go ahead that this makes sense to me. So to maximize revenue, I want to go ahead and find this derivative, r prime of p is equal to 360 minus 6p, and set it equal to 0. So let's go down. I get this critical values. P I get is equal to 60. The price should be $60 in order to maximize revenue. Okay? Now, you can also do, if you want to convince yourself that this is an absolute maximum for this particular function, you can do this interval test. Let's say price from 0 to 60, although we're kind of starting, to be honest, at a price of what, like $50? I mean, we really didn't talk about, and 60 kind of on up to whatever it is until you kind of run to the end of the reality here. But if you do this and you test f prime, let's get a test point in here. 55. And a test point out here. Let's use something reasonable, 65. F prime of the test point. Let's see. So y, oops, clear, 360. Minus 30. So you get 30 and minus 30 here. So here you get that it's increasing and here decreasing, right? So you get this maximal value. There's no other place for this to be a maximum. So this point at 60 has to be my absolute maximum. So then the actual revenue at 60 at a price of $60, right? I'll plug that back into my original revenue function. Let me go up. The original revenue function, remember, r of x, 360p minus 3p squared. So r of 60, r of p here. 360 times $60 squared. And let's plug that in. Okay, so can you guys do that with me? 360 times 60. Minus 3. And the maximal revenue is $10,800. Okay. So the maximum revenue is $10,800 when rooms are priced at $60 each. Okay, so go back through if you're were confused about the modeling. If you have questions, you can rewatch the video or come ask me questions. But this kind of modeling, the original problem, is a little bit more complicated, but we need to be able to kind of get there. And in this particular problem, that pattern recognition, making a table, I think was helpful. Okay, let me know if you have questions.